And there was a moment around media day where you talked about you being the sixth man. You were like, I hadn't heard that yet. At what point for an NBA player, you played with a bunch of different coaches. At what point does a coach talk to you about your role? And has that happened with Coach Kidd yet?
I mean, it hasn't had haven't happened one-on-one, but you kind of get a sense. Like I said, I'm kind of like a hybrid at this point. Start, come off the bench. I just want to hoop. Just want to play, just want to hoop. Go from there. So wherever situation, role he plays me at this point, I mean, it's time to go.
Have you had conversations with other coaches in the past? And when did that kind of happen?
No.
How would you evaluate the 12-day trip on and off the court?
It was great. I mean, great team bonding. Great way for guys to get to know one another on and off the floor, know each other's tendencies, get to know the coaching staff, new coaches that's on the staff. So it was cool. It was fun, especially to have family out there. Great to see them. Oh, man. We had fun. We had a great time. Even though we lost a couple games, but I think for the most part, what we got out of it was building that team chemistry.
It's not uncommon to have injuries during training camp. You guys are dealing with a few now. Do you have any level of concern about getting ready for the start of the season?
Nope. All we could do is control what you can control as an individual and as a guy on this team. And one thing is for sure that, you know, you just got to make sure your body's healthy, make sure you're taking care of your body, make sure you're ready for anything that happens or comes your way. So I think individually, I mean, and selfishly, you know, you got to look at yourself and make sure that you know, are healthy and make sure that you are ready just in case anything like that ever happens to any other player on your team, because you never know when your name is going to get called. So, yeah.
We've talked about rebounding and how it's, you know, effort and energy and all that, but is it also a matter of being physical, especially when the big guys have another guy locked up and the wings and people like yourself have to get in there and help out?
Yeah, I mean, it's a little bit of everything that you put in there, a little bit of tenacity, a little bit of effort, a little bit of luck, you know, being at the right spot at the right time. So, I think for the most part, helping out the bigs, they're going to let you get away with a little things, with a little push in the back here and there, but, you know, just try to get down there, be physical, and do the best you can and to help the bigs.
Grant was saying yesterday that, you know, go ahead and risk the loose ball foul.
You got to make it happen. You know, like I said, the refs can only see so much, you know. But if you're out there being aggressive, for the most part, and you are out hustling the other opponent, most likely, you know, they're not going to call anything on you. They're going to reward the guys that are out there going hard and giving it their best.
I feel like the level of physicality is higher with this particular roster, this group?
It's higher. Vocally, it's higher. And spiritually, it's higher. And us guys know what we have to do in order to make sure we make the two guys' life a lot easier. I don't have to name them two, but everybody knows. We just got to do a great job of taking care of ourselves, like I said, off the court, but making sure that on the court that we're bringing that fire and that passion, that energy, to make sure we gain that trust and gain those guys' confidence while we're out there on the floor.
Speaking of passion, what is your thoughts on the way they're going to be looking at the flopping calls and the theatrical side is what they're trying to, the referees cut out really to, when you hear it from the league side of it, really so that the game can be taken to a higher level?
Yeah.
What's your response as a player?
As a player, I mean, I understand what they're trying to do. I mean, we're gonna have a meeting with the guys, with the referees and everybody like that tomorrow. So we'll get a better understanding of that question tomorrow. But for me as a guy that takes a lot of charges, I just gotta make sure I'm careful and make sure that I'm not flopping. I mean, I'm not trying to say I'm a flopper, but I do. You know, you do have to sell the play here and there. It's the guy with the naked eye that's going to make that call, whether it's a charge or not. So, you know, all I can do is just be in position.
Last
through three preseason games, what are your thoughts on how Derek Lively is kind of handling adjusting to the NBA, like coverages and things like that?
He's doing great. I think for the most part, the more practices are helping him out. You know, you can only do so much in summer league with those guys, but when you're actually on the roster and you're with the veterans and the guys are out there giving you knowledge and he's being that sponge, it's definitely going to help him. And he's going to help us. You know, the more vocal he is, the more it gives us perimeter defenders to be aggressive out there on the perimeter and get into the ball and make sure that we don't put him in situations where he'll be stuck in a bind or get in foul trouble.
But your last game is against Real Madrid, obviously a very different style than like the Minnesota Timberwolves. Does that, facing different types of teams like that, does that potentially help you guys as you prepare for the season?
Yeah, I mean, Real shot a lot of threes. You know, Minnesota shoots some threes, but, you know, they got those two big guys down there in the paint that they're playing off of. And then you got Ant coming downhill that can also shoot the ball. So, you know, it was a little bit of everything. One team had a lot of ball movement, a lot of moving parts. The other guys, been together for a little while and, you know, they're playing with two 7-foot guys. So you're not going to really see that as much as throughout the whole entire season, but it was great just to get an opportunity to play against those guys.
I haven't done the math, but I'm guessing there's more new guys than there are guys who were here for the conference finals run. What's your sense of like how the team is approaching this year? Do you think there's any residual from 2 years ago wanting to get back to that, or do you feel like this is more of a clean slate?
It's more of a clean slate, but also we know how important it is to get to a great start. We got to get to a great start in the season, not dig ourselves a hole, and make sure like you touched on it before, make sure we're going into this thing healthy. Things happen. But you know, at the end of the day, we got to take care of our business and make sure that we get to a really, really great start.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Oh, let me do medical. Kai participated. He was great. Did the whole practice, literally did the whole practice. And then Lucas still being evaluated. So we'll see how he feels as the week goes on. Hardy sprained his ankle today, so he's getting treatment, so we'll see how he feels. Josh hurt himself yesterday. He fell on his back, so he was out today, and we'll see how he feels, and hopefully he's back tomorrow, but we'll see.
Wow, that was a lot.
Just another day of practice.
I guess so. Are you concerned that might be a setback for Josh? I mean, here he is battling for a starting position. Do you see this as a potential multi-day thing?
Yeah, I think he was moving well today. I think we're very happy with his movement. We'll see how he feels tomorrow. Is it a setback? I don't think it's a setback. I think it's just give someone an opportunity if he can't go Friday or tomorrow, another opportunity for us as coaches and teammates to see someone in that position be able to see how they handle that. Again, today Exum was in that situation, so I thought Exum did an incredible job today in practice with Kai in the backcourt.
Jason, how do you feel you'll be
Prepared
process of trying to get your guys to play faster, get into their style faster? How do you think that's going to
work? Yeah, I think it's to play faster is a good question, Coop. I think when you look at playing faster, we got the clock shorter, so they got to throw it ahead, and we're trying to get guys to throw the ball ahead, to play faster on that catch, to attack, to get a paint touch, and then play from there. Our norm, I think, with Luka is to walk the ball up. With Luka out, we're playing faster. And then once we get him back, we got to continue to keep playing faster.
Can you play faster within the half court, even in a walk, like just even get into the set faster and the action faster?
Yeah, you got to throw the ball ahead. We got to throw the ball ahead. We can't walk it. To play faster, the ball has to get across half court, and you got to be able to throw it ahead and have playmakers who can then, make decisions from that. And we feel we have that. So we look forward to trying to play faster as the season goes on. But we got to get healthy, first and foremost. Our health is right now not in a good situation, but hopefully as we've gotten Kai back, hopefully we get these other guys back too.
Jason, what do you like about Dexter Dennis? I mean, we've
was saying about himself.
Yeah, I think you talk about his athleticism, his toughness, his ability to play defense, and then his ability, you know, to stretch the defense, to shoot the threes, working on that. And I just like his energy. He's been great in camp for us. He's still here with us. And so, you know, looking at what he does on both ends of the floor is something that we probably need as the season goes on.
He can jump out of gym, can't he?
He's athletic for sure. Again, that helps us. That was an area that we lacked last year. So I think it's good to have someone like that that we can call on. If there's injuries, he's able to defend, and then he's capable of three-point shooting.
Do you view Friday as any way of a dress rehearsal, or is that even possible since you don't have a full roster right now?
Great question. Don't have a full roster, won't know, so I don't know if we can call it a dress rehearsal. But for those who do dress, if there are guys that are starters or guys who are, you know, in the rotation, hopefully we can get their minutes up, in the 20s like we did with Real Madrid.
We talked about rebounding being the final part of a good defensive stand.
Yeah.
How much of that, we also heard that rebounding is about effort and energy, but is there also some physicality that has to be brought for this team in terms of getting, especially defensive rebounds and not giving up second shots?
Yeah, we talk about defense, you know, finishing it with a rebound, but you have to start, the fight has to start earlier when the shot is, you know, being taken. We got to be physical. We can't just arm bar and hope that we're going to use our athleticism, especially with today's game, a lot of threes being taken, we always think about the bigs being the rebounders, but it's also the mediums that have to participate. The guards and the wings have to come back, and we believe with the Derrick Jones is that we have guys that can now compete to be able to come up with those rebounds.
Grant yesterday was saying that whenever somebody's locked up with the other big guy, somebody has to come and, risking loose ball fouls or whatever, get the rebound somehow.
Yeah, it's a partnership, and so it's, it takes all five to rebound, and we believe that we have that, when we look at the group that could be starting, that we have a group that can rebound.
Luka's injury, we seem to have some left leg issues for a while now. Has there been any talk about him sitting out for an extended period of time to try and get him right in that area, or are you thinking ready for it?
Yeah, that's a great question. That's out of my pay grade. I'm only here to report what the statement is, and so that I'm gonna stick to that. We'll see when he's. I'll tell you when he's clear to go. Right now, he's not clear to go, but hopefully here we have a better understanding where he's at in the next couple of days.
Jason, what's it been like to have Kyrie in camp? I mean, you obviously didn't have that experience last year. Didn't have a lot of practice time at the end of last year together either. What's he like in terms of his process, seeing it to get ready for a season?
Yeah, it's been great to have him here for training camp. Unfortunately, we have some injuries. We would like everybody to be healthy, but he's been great. He's a leader. He's taken this group. With the leadership of understanding the late game, talking about different things that he likes, but also what his teammates like. And I think just the relationship, the bond of being able to talk to one another, to understand each other better on the floor is very important. And I think he's taken that leadership to heart to try to help understand each guy, but also to understand what he's capable of doing. And I think the training camp has helped with that.
What did you like about the tip-off event last night, what the Mavs Foundation has been able to do in the community?
Yeah, I think it's incredible with the Mavs Foundation to be able to raise that type of money, to have that type of influence in the community is huge, and that's what the Mavs have done, and they continue to do at a very high level.
How would you describe Kyrie's leadership style?
Very calm. I think approachable, and very knowledgeable, and it's about the journey. I think he said that last night. Being able to help the younger guys or just his teammates with their journey to be able to help them, be successful on the floor.
Yesterday, the bigs, for what the Carter Paxson saw, were working on ice coverage and gear switching, and today they're working on post defense. How are your thoughts on Lively handling those situations in the season?
Yeah, he's doing a really good job. He's a rookie. He's going to make mistakes. And so, you know, being able to work in practice on those different aspects of the defense is going to help him. You know, looking at him with the second group, you know, this week, he's not with the starters, so that has actually helped him too. But he's been really good with both sides, both teams, the first and second team. So, but he's a rookie, and he's made some mistakes, but that's a given. So we're just trying to put him in a situation to be successful, and he's doing the work, and we're happy where he's at right now as a rookie.
How important is it that he's a willing communicator as like the defensive anchor early in his career?
It's big. You know, you see the influence that Tyson's had, you know, being able to talk as a rookie. You know, a lot of times rookies aren't allowed to say much, but with his voice being the anchor of that group, whatever it's the first group or second group, he's done a really good job. Now the next step is just the positioning of what he's saying, and once that matches, then he's going to be in a really good spot.
Yeah, time to stop and see what the Rangers been doing in the playoffs.
Yeah, they're rolling. You know, that pitching defense at this time of the year is key, and I think we talked about it last year. Just the calmness of the two, you know, older managers in the AL, you know, series just shows. You know, it's a journey, and those guys, you know, right now Texas is playing extremely well. Confidence is high, but you know they're playing against a very talented team, so the series is far from over. But it's exciting for the state of Texas to have two teams in it.
Thank you.
Thank you.